quietly put together a nice little 3-fight winning streak, 5-1 in your last 6, man. I got to feel that you're feeling pretty happy with where your career's at right now.
Yeah, it's just an example of just the success that Team Elevation puts together with my coaching staff and everything else. And I feel like I'm really coming into my potential. 3-fight win streak isn't enough. We want more.
It's impressive. I mean, no matter where you're at in your career, no matter what division you're in, I mean, doing that in the UFC is impressive. Do you feel like maybe it's not getting the attention that it deserves? I mean, I know there's a ton of people in both the divisions that you've competed in, but do you feel like maybe you're not getting the love that you should for it?
Possibly. I signed with a new management group and we're hoping to change that. But, I mean, honestly, the love and the popularity is on my end. It's what I can control. And so I just go out there, perform my best, have a fantastic fight, and then outside the cage, being able to communicate with my fans, and then having more opportunity in the limelight is what my goals are.
So has that been the strategy, like, since the new management group? Is that, like, things you've been talking about, is how to kind of advance your career?
Yeah, pretty much. Is how many times can I be put in front of the limelight? Just with in and out of the cage, you know, as many fights as I possibly can in a year. I mean, I'm only getting older, so just try to get as many fights as possible. And then when I'm outside the cage, any possible time I can talk with like friends, family, and fans.
It's such a unique balance, right? Because, I mean, in any other sport, I think, maybe it's not, but it feels like you just win and that's all that matters. Here, you got to win and entertain too, right? Is that difficult for you to grasp or to have to balance that?
No, I'm a firm believer that I'm a fighter and an entertainer. I mean, the people that give me the opportunity to do this is the fans. And the fact that, like, I get to perform martial arts in front of, like, a group of people that, like, absolutely love what I do is absolutely fantastic. And any opportunity I get to speak with these people that like just cherish my fights as much as I do, like I love talking with them.
Very cool. We had the big win in Nebraska that we talked about. I know that was a big kind of emotional night for you, but it's been 7 months. Give me an idea. I thought you might want to build on that a little bit. What happened between now and then?
Well, that's a prime example of why I hired a management company, because it was too long. I was requesting fights, and it wasn't like nothing was coming up from it. So, yeah, of course I wanted to ride the win streak and continue that momentum. I was patient. I got this fight, which this fight is fantastic. But, yeah, I'm not satisfied with only fighting twice a year. I want more than that.
Were you self-managed before that?
Yes.
Well, that's an interesting approach, right? Would you recommend it to other people, or is it a little tough to pull off?
It's different when you got, I mean, it all just depends on who, you know, who's managing you. And, like, if you don't have a good opportunity or, like, a good resource, then I'd say manage yourself. And then, of course, learning how to manage yourself is a good quality to have. And then after you learn to manage yourself, now I give that burden to somebody else, and now they're helping best represent me.
Awesome. I noticed you got your brown belt in the meantime between now and then, right? I always find it interesting because you guys are chasing world titles, but I feel like sometimes when you get these belt promotions, it means almost as much as that. I mean, what did that moment mean to you?
Oh, it was fantastic. It was utterly surprising. Like, I had no idea. I was actually just doing some jiu-jitsu training after my fight, and then I just started getting whipped up by a brown belt by Elliot Marshall. And, yeah, it just means a lot. It's just it's another accomplishment in a long series of accomplishments in this career. It's something you add to the resume, and it's something that's forever. I mean, no one can ever take that away from me.
So you sign on with the new management group. The first matchup you get, Beneil Dariush. Give me an idea. When you heard that name, did you think, these are the type of matchups I want? I mean, that's what I hired you for. Were you excited about it? What did you think about this one?
Yeah, exactly. I was super excited. You know, I've been a fan of Beneil's, you know, in his last couple fights. And, like, he looks fantastic. His skill set, his martial arts, his composure, like, he's fantastic. He's, you know, quality of a top 10 opponent. And so this opportunity and being able to showcase my abilities against a guy that's so talented, it brings just so much excitement out. And I just can't wait.
He's had some setbacks, but as you said, I mean, he's been in the rankings and he's got striking, he's got jiu-jitsu. So, I mean, how do you see your guys' style matching up? Is this going to be a strategic type of fight, or is this going to be more just go out there and bang? What type of fight is this going to be?
Well, unfortunately, you know, I'm a very theatrical fighter, and so I usually come out and, you know, stand and trade. But I have a lot of skill set, you know, a lot of improvements in my last fight that I want to come in and showcase. I definitely got to be weary. I mean, Beneil, like, he's gotten caught, but, like, that's the thing. He's got caught, but, you know, the fights that he's winning, he wins well. And so he's a dangerous opponent, but I'm just so excited just being able to, like, showcase my skill set against something that's so dangerous. And it's like, that is what excites me. And I have 15 minutes to show everyone what I've been working on.
Main card matchup. I mean, I feel like you guys are kind of tucked right between, like, you got the marquee names at the top, and then you guys like that right one underneath it. I mean, do you feel like this is a big moment for you? Do you feel like this is an opportunity to maybe get that respect that you haven't gotten in this win streak so far?
Yeah, I think I fall on the main card where it's like the featured fight. You know, these are the fights that kind of warm people up. Like, these are the fights that get people excited for that co and main event. And then the last card with that, Robbie Lawler and Ben Askren, like, you know, some of the lower like fights on the main card are absolutely fantastic. And so being able to be placed in that same position, it's just like, all right, like, I'm ready to perform for everyone.
Fantastic. Well, it feels like you feel like this is kind of a moment to break out. So when you play this out in your head, I mean, how do you see this going out? Do you feel like you're going to have to go out and be tested and battle through something? Or do you feel like you can go out there and be dominant and send a message? How do you feel this thing goes?
I'm a firm believer when it comes to, you know, adding a number in front of your name, it's not who you fight, it's how you fight. And so I have 15 minutes to go out there and just have tons of fun and showcase to everyone my abilities and just my finishing power. And so, yeah, of course I'm going to be chasing them for that finish and looking for that finish for 15 minutes, because nobody wants to watch a, you know, boring wrestle fest. Everyone wants to see, you know, what they paid money to see, and I'm willing to give it to them.